Hello everybody, you're looking at a picture of spindle drives which raise and lower the tailgate on a 2012 BMW X5 E70 series. I originally thought these had failed, so I started to do some research on these to understand how they worked, and I thought I'd share my findings with you. The spindle drives are really expensive, so the first thing I would recommend you do is look in this lower right hand compartment. This is the tailgate control module. If you're like many of us, you will find this module right here, which is sitting inside this holder, is sitting in a couple of inches of water. If your tailgate is unlocking, in other words, if you press the key or press the button from the dash and the tailgate unlocks but does not raise up, or if you push the button and the tailgate will not lower down automatically, may not be the motorized struts. It is very possible it's the tailgate control module. In fact, that's the exact problem I had. My problem turned out not to be the spindle drives located here and here. It turned out to be the control module. So check out the link in the upper right hand corner here if you want to see how I replaced the tailgate control module and that it works without any coating. According to BMW's technical information system, the spindle drive has a motor and it has two Hall effect sensors. This diagram shows item number 5, but there are two Hall effect sensors. It's my understanding that the Hall effect sensors are used to count the revolutions clockwise and counterclockwise, which helps the computers decide what position it's in, because from the iDrive you're able to select a partially open position. Those of you who are really interested in the nitty-gritty, here's a schematic diagram. Right here is the right side. Item number 5 is the right side passenger side on a US drive car, spindle drive motor, and then items 6 and 7 are the Hall effect sensors for the right hand side. You can see here 6, 7 Hall effect sensor right. Over here on this side, item 21 is a spindle drive motor on the left side, and it has two Hall effect sensors as well. Items 19 and 20, which are shown right here and here. This tells you that there should be 5 wires coming out from each spindle drive, 2 for the motor and 3 for the Hall effect sensors, with one of the 3 Hall effect sensor connections being common to both of the sensors. You see the red and black wires here, red and black wires here. Those are for the 12 volts DC. And when 12 volts is connected in one direction, let's say positive to the red, negative to the black, the motors rotate in one direction, and when you reverse the polarity, positive to the black and negative to the red, the motors run in the opposite direction. The other connector has 3 wires each, and those are the 3 wires which connect to the Hall effect sensors. You also notice that on one of the spindle drives that the plugs are black, and on the other spindle drive the plugs are white. I believe, but don't hold me to this, I believe that the black are on the driver's side and the white are on the passenger side on a left-hand drive car. Here's a close-up view of what those connectors look like. You'll notice here that pins 1, 2, and 3 are there, and pins 4, 5, and 6 are black. Those are the 1, 2, 3 connections for the Hall effect sensors, and these two larger connectors here and here are for the 12 volt DC power. Same holds true on this side, pins 1, 2, and 3 on the white connector, as well as the 12 volt DC power connector. For those of you who are interested, here are the current part numbers for the left and right spindle drives. This one right here, and this one right here, and this applies to the 2012 X5. I'm sure it applies to other model years, but I can definitely confirm that it applies to the 2012 X5 produced after March of 2011. For those of you unfortunate enough to have to replace these, and I say unfortunate because these are really, really expensive, you might be a little confused by pictures that look like this, or even like this. This piece right here is used to fish the wire and plug down through the body of the car, generally down through the D-pillar, to connect to the main wiring harness. And this piece here ends up being removed after you fish the wire and plug down to where it need to be. So don't be confused by some of the pictures, which will show this, where you're not able to see the plug. The plug is in fact inside here. So once you get the harness and plugs and wires in place, all this is removed and thrown away. But the black plugs or the white plugs are inside this covering here. This covering is thrown away once you get the wires fished into their correct position. So that wraps up my tutorial on the spindle drives or power struts. I'm sure it applies to other vehicles as well, not just the BMW. Almost any vehicle that has these power lift gates or power tailgates. So thanks for watching. If you found this helpful or at all informative, how about a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.